Hi. Let's say you have a website that you've made at Stony Brook University while you've been a student, and you've done it inside of Google Sites at Stony Brook. You're going to have a URL that looks something like the one up at the top of this page. It's inside of the Stony Brook domain. Now, if you're going to leave the university and you want to preserve your site, your account will be deactivated, so you're going to have to take this site with you. That's what this is about. We're going to show you how to move your site from a Stony Brook domain to a private Gmail domain. We're going to use this share button to start the process of moving your website from the Stony Brook domain off onto a private Gmail domain. Okay, so the first thing that I want to do now is add your private account as an owner to this website. I'm going to add my Stony Brook SBU video address and use that as a demonstration. I'm going to change this to not be can edit, but is owner, and share and save. I'm going to confirm that even though this person isn't in the organization, that's who I want to send this to. Now what I'm going to do is open up a different browser window. Oops, has to be a different browser so I can show you at the same time. Okay, so here's Firefox, and here's that address. Okay, so here you go. Here's a notification that I got from my Stony Brook address site saying I've shared the ownership of this site. So now, from my private site, this is not the Stony Brook site, I'm going to go ahead in and go to that web page. Now I can go to Manage Site, and I'm going to click this button here. It says Copy This Site. And I'm going to give the site a name. And as you can see down here, it's giving it a new URL that is not inside the Stony Brook domain. I don't know if this URL is going to be available or not. Let's see, I'll just do just to make sure it's available. And then type the code to show that I'm not a robot, I am indeed a person. And that's it. Now the website that used to be on Stony Brook campus is now on a private address. So you don't have to worry about creating sites at campus on the Stony Brook website and what's going to happen to them when you leave. That's the process, and it's really easy. I hope this has been informative. If you have any other questions, please feel free to contact me.